क्वेश्चन इज शो दैट जी ऑफ एक्स डिफाइंड एज एक्स माइनस ग्रेटेस्ट इंटीजर फंक्शन एक्स इज डिसकंटिन्यूअस. नाउ व्हाट इज ग्रेटेस्ट इंटीजर फंक्शन? वी नो सपोज 1, 2 and 3. सो ऑल वैल्यूज बिटवीन 1 and 2 विल गिव ग्रेटेस्ट इंटीजर एज 1, इजंट इट? 1.1 ग्रेटेस्ट इंटीजर 1.1, 1.2, 1.3, even 1.9 also will give answer as 1. Okay, all values between 2 and 3 will give answer as 2. 2.1, 2.2, 2.3, 2.9 will be 2 only. So similarly, if we consider a point, now here it is not given at which point integral point is given. So one integral point, arbitrary integral point will consider a. So next number will be a plus 1 and preceding number will be a minus 1, isn't it? So all the values between a and a plus 1 will give integer function as a answer. Okay, so here we will consider, suppose a small increment h. So all values here will be of the type a plus h. So all values a plus h will give integer function as smaller one, isn't it? And here if we consider all values of the type a minus h, h is a small increment or a small negligible number, you can say. If you subtract from a, you will get values in between a to a minus 1. So for integer function a minus h, greatest integer function of this will be a minus 1, isn't it? So accordingly here we have to substitute and find that if whether function is continuous or not. Show that means it will be discontinuous only. So let a be any arbitrary integral point. Okay, so to check, limit x tends to a plus f of x, limit x tends to a minus f of x equals to f of a. Now limit x tends to a plus, now here function is g of x, so better write g form. Okay, now limit x tends to a x minus integral greatest integer of x. So here for x a plus, what we will do, we'll substitute a plus h. X greater than a means x will be of the type a plus h, isn't it? Where x tends to 0, substitution method, remember class 11, h tends to 0. So we will substitute h tends to 0, x is a plus h, and here greatest integer of a plus h. Now this will be a plus h only, but what about this greatest integer? It will come as a plus h, greatest integer of a plus h will be a, isn't it? Just now we saw, so a minus a will go, so limit h tends to 0, h will be answer 0. This will be your equation 1. Okay, similarly we have to suppose for the left hand limit, this is right hand limit, x tends to a plus means right hand limit. So 0 we got, remember the answer 0. Now x tends to a minus, x tends to a minus means this is a minus 1, so a minus means a minus h, this type. So again we'll substitute here, put x equal to a minus h, as x tends to a, h tends to 0. Okay, so limit h tends to 0, x is a minus h minus x is a minus h. Okay, now this is not greatest integer function, simple bracket. Now limit h tends to 0, a minus h, greatest integer of a minus h will give a minus 1 is answer. So a minus 1. Now we'll open the bracket. A minus h minus a plus 1, a will go, and after substituting the limit we'll get this will be 0 and answer will be 1. So this is equation 2. Okay, and now we can find for, see here also g of x, right? G of x everywhere. Okay, now to find for g of a, g of a we will find here. Actually no need to find, we got both the limits are different value, they have different value. One is 0, one is, second one is 1. So we'll find, suppose g of a, so g of a will be a minus greatest integer a, a minus a will be 0. So equation 3. So from 1, 2 and 3 what we can write? Limit x tends to a plus f of x is not equal to limit x tends to a minus f of x is not equal to f g of x. G of a, that implies g is discontinuous at a, that implies g is discontinuous at all integral points, because this one is arbitrary integral points.